associated with this are Felicity Huffman and Lori Loughlin. We've had Lori on a ton of times, and she's just really loved her.
Yeah,
a couple weeks ago.
And this one hurts.
And they all, I hate these kinds of stories to begin with, but I've known Lori since she was 16 when she first went on The Edge of Night.
Yeah.
And I've always loved her to pieces, still do. Don't understand this, but I look for a number for her, just so I can just reach out. No judgment. When they're your friends, they're your friends. But she's not the kind of friend that I have her number. Right. You know what I mean? She's just a colleague that I love
this,
her.
This, yeah.
Sick of it. I want her to know that. The story is, and this is what the prosecutors are alleging, that she and her husband paid about $500 million to have their two daughters, try to get into USC. And basically, the prosecution's alleging that they did these sort of faux photos of the daughters on a crew team when they weren't ever in crew. And in some cases, this fixer guy would Photoshop faces of the girls onto bodies. That's what he did for some of them athletes. So it looked as if they were on a crew team. And they ended up firing some coaches, charging some coaches from these various universities. It's USC, it was Yale, and there were a ton of schools. Stanford, a lot of Ivy League. So
those are the ones that were just literally dying to get.
I think the reason that this spoke to so many people and made people so upset is there are a lot of kids who are working two jobs, taking their SAT a couple of times to try to get a decent grade,
trying to get tutors, and
trying to do extracurricular at school, everything, because they don't have any connection. They just have to.
Or money.
So they don't have any. They just need to get in, and they can't get in. And you're banging on the door, and you just can't get in. And then you see stories of other kids who do get in, who didn't have what you had, but had something else.
So you know what some people will say? Well, listen, they're just trying to do the best. Some people have said this, or
trying to do the best
for their kids. I said, are you teaching your kids that it's okay? That's the way you're going to handle life. You cheat, you lie.
Right.
That's not the best for your kids.
Right.
The best for your kids is teaching them right from wrong.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then being an example of it.
Yes.
Not that I've always been, but I did. I taught my kids that they're better people than I am.
They were told to say that they couldn't come on the designated day because it was like a wedding or a bar mitzvah or something. I can't make it, so I need to switch my day. So they would, and in switching it, they got into a room that was friendly to this guy, Wayne Singer. More private room. And then that's when apparently there was some kid who would, in some cases, take the SAT for you. And in some cases,
or you take your answers and
mix the answers and
put the test in.
So what are the repercussions? And we're going to have a whole segment on this with some experts in a little bit.
What now happens to somebody like Lori, who's been beloved in this industry, has got one of the biggest shows on the Hallmark Channel. She was Aunt Becky. She was Full House, Fuller House. She's at Hallmark. She's got maybe one of the best images.
Yes.
Of any actress on television.
One thing that one of the prosecutors was saying, because it is mail fraud, this is like a real crime they were talking about.
It's a federal crime.
I mean, it is punishable by some prison time.
That's what they said.
I know, that took my breath away too. I don't think the thinking is that would ever happen. I think it would.
But there was some talk that maybe her passport might be taken away. She works almost all the time in Bangalore. That's where Hallmark does so many of their films. I wonder if she's going to still have a job.
And the prosecutors can say they weren't going after the kids. In some cases, the kids didn't know what was going on. In some cases, they did. They knew someone else was taking their test, obviously. But
so let's put ourselves in. Say we didn't know our parents were doing that. Your parents wouldn't have, and mine wouldn't have. But say we've grown up in a privileged home. Neither of us did.
Right.
I don't know what that's like. How would you be feeling this morning?
Right. If you knew that your parents, secretly were trying to pay someone to get you into school, I feel pretty crummy.
I would rather do your self-worth, mom and dad, you didn't think I could do it on my own?
I'd rather, get into any kind of community college or anything. state school, find a school. There's no way I could get in right now. Like, the grade point and your SAT scores, in addition to the extracurricular, like, every, I don't know how kids get into college. Where are they going?
Well, maybe now we're learning.
Yeah. Well, some of those kids, but what about the kids who don't have that?
Like, it's been a long time since my kids.
And the cost of it, I mean, there's a lot attached to it, but this is hitting a nerve for a ton of reasons.
Well, it just goes back to what so many people think, that the whole system is rigged for the rich.
Right.
And in some cases it is, let's be honest. So let's fix it.
Look, if a guy wants his kid to get into a big school and says, I have a $250,000 donation for your library,
which is
and they say, right, it is legal, but it's also like,